Now I will read that word that I heard the Bible but never read. Now I must read it. Daniel chapter 10. You know, I heard the Bible in the morning. And I remember I just explained, but I didn't read. So now I want to read it. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 10, are you there? You are there, you say yes.
Yes.
10:10. I begin from 10. The Bible says, suddenly a hand touched me, which made me tremble on my knees and on the palms of my hands. And he said to me, O Daniel, man greatly loved, understand the words that I speak to you, and stand upright, for I have now been sent to you. While he was speaking this word to me, I stood trembling. This is Daniel speaking. Verse 12, then he said to me, do not fear, Daniel, for the first day that you set your heart to understand and to humble yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come because of your words. Now this is the Lord talking to Daniel. He's on his knees, he's praying. And he's trembling as Michael has just come and touched him, an angel. Amen? So I was trying to say in the morning, you can pray to a level where you may feel like somebody's even touched you. Amen? And do not forget that there are still hindrances. You will hear somebody is crying outside your house. Don't go. Your phone can ring, don't pick. When you are praying, honor God more than the things that you see every day. Even if somebody very important whom you are, whom maybe that person was supposed to give you the money for the meal of that day, don't pick it even when you are praying. What matters? God should matter more. Amen? Yes, maybe God didn't want you to be blessed through that. So when you break the cycle of God, then you will make time for some time somewhere. You would grow rapidly as the Lord would have wanted. Verse 13. But the prince of kingdom of Persia withstood me 21 days. And behold, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. For I had been left alone there with the kings of Persia. When Daniel was praying, his answer had come. For 21 days, the king of Persia withstood that answer that he may not reach him. This is why when Tony was speaking in the morning, he was saying, you may pray for a long time, but if you are not keying in the Spirit, you are wasting your time. Amen? We are here, as my brother said, we seem to be all worshippers, all people in the worship team. Now the question is, are we all worshippers? Is there a time when you can go in spirit? And do you really know when you are in spirit? That's what now matters. That is why when my brother starts to preach, he can ramble in tongues. And he can declare when there is too much power, he can say, he can agree that there is. When there's confusion, he will tell you there's confusion. Why? Because the Lord has illuminated in him the ability to see what we don't see, what we can see. But also, we still have that ability to pray on and to pray until we reach that. We can all reach that. In fact, as praise and worship, I want to challenge you guys. As praise and worship, we must be elevated to the extent that we can know what next. Now, I want you to gauge this. If at all the word that I gave, or the admonition that I was giving them, I was telling you, hear what the Lord is saying. Is that what were those not my words? Hear what the Lord is saying. There are levels. You can pray and another level comes. You can pray, then another level comes. You can pray, then another level comes. I didn't know that Brazil was going to come and talk about levels. I never knew. But now when he came and brought it down consequentially, I knew that this was God speaking. It is not very, very easy for somebody to say, the Lord is speaking. It is not very easy. And if at all it is so, then you may confirm by what came later. Because when he spoke, then I said, oh, so the Lord was speaking. Those that lead the pack of people must know what direction you must. There is an inner ear. There is something that is illuminated. In fact, the song that I started with singing, yeah, I'm not fond of singing it, but I was also saying that. Mataifa yote yatakusanyika. You know, when I sing it, it always pulls my vocal cords off, but I decided to sing it. And as I sang it, the Spirit of God came so mighty. I said, oh, this is why they don't want this song. So, just as you have said, there are songs for a particular time. There are songs for a particular time. Shetani nitakusema, kwa baba nitakusema. There are times for that. Eh? Tumezunguka. There's a time for that. You only zunguka when you are happy. You won't tell me somebody wants to repent there, then unamzungusha. Namzungushia nini na adaa kutubu. Mimi kataa kutubu bwana. Lete nyimbo ya toba. Damu ya Yesu safisha kabisa then. So there is a way to see, there are songs to sing at what time, for what purpose there is. So you are very much on point, brother, and that is very good. Amen. So here we are, all people. So I'm continuing, verse 14. Now I have come to make you understand what will happen to our people in the latter days, for the vision refers to many days yet to come. Verse 15. When he has spoken such words to me, I turned my face toward the ground and became speechless. This is Daniel, still praying before God. And then he's trembling. The angel touches the lips. Why? I want to tell us a very big secret. Tony was asking us, how many can pray for 3 hours? No hand went up. Every day, for the next 7 minutes, nobody, no hand went up. How many can pray for 2 hours? Now there were some good thoughts. So they flashed out. Some did that, isn't it? I want to tell you something. It is the Lord who empowers us to pray on. I want to give us a credit somewhere. Today, the prayer was very good. It was all right. It was very much in tune. Now, the prompting that I want to give us is, when you are praying privately, we were told that there are 3 types of prayers, isn't it? So, in that personal realm where you are praying alone, you are maybe praying in your house, and you can rise and sing and cry and yell and pray as you purport. Good, do it. But remember that there is a spiritual language that the Lord prompts. Them that have been granted the ability to dwell in tongues, there is a way when you pray and read somewhere. The angel comes and touches your lips so that the tongues are changed. Then you pray again along that lane, in that level. Then maybe for 1 hour, you can double, that's 1 hour, the tongues are changed again. This is not now within your ability. In fact, there is something that has overtaken you. Now it is not you. This is why, as you can see in verse 15, verse 16 says, and suddenly, one having the likeness of the sons of men touched my lips. Then I opened my mouth and spoke, saying to him who stood before me, my Lord, because of the vision, my sorrows have overwhelmed me, and I have retained no strength. He had no strength when he was rambling in that dance. So when the when the angel came, touched the lips, and another level came in. Amen. This is what happens. Then even as he continues, you say verse 17, for how can this servant of the Lord talk with you, my Lord? As for me, no strength remains in me now, nor is there, nor is any breath left in me. Verse 18. Then again, the one having the likeness of a man touched me and strengthened me. Amen. So we when you are before the Lord, you know, he had prayed as if he was so lifeless. He was so, he had no strength. Maybe he had even fasted and prayed there longer. So he had not eaten. Yeah, so the Lord, he cried for some strength. The lips were touched, strength came. Amen? So I believe that as we go before the Lord during this week, even if you have not been able to get some bundles to go online, but pray outside there and pray deeply. Learn to pray in the Spirit. Just pray and pray. And I believe that that strength shall come. Verse 19. And he said, O man, greatly beloved, fear not. Peace to you. Be strong. Yes, be strong. So when he spoke to me, I was strengthened and said, let my Lord speak, for you have strengthened me. Allow me to finish. Then he said, do I know why I have to come to you? And now I must return to fight with the prince of Persia. And when I have gone forth, indeed the prince of Greece will come. Now you see, there is the prince of Persia who withheld. Now he was going back to re-energize. The way I like the way brother put it, brother Tony put it, that for you to run, to go on to the next level, it's like a catapult, fair? You're fair. You pull, you go back a little bit, then you leave, you let the stone go over. This is how our faith, even our prayers should be. So you go back a bit and then you hurl to the next level. This is just when we are so adamant before God, when we are consistent, when we are there, when, in fact, he was speaking something like, you can't just pray on your own, but the Lord can prompt you by a still small voice. Yes, the still small voice comes, so the song, it's not a must. When the prayer comes, but even if you are in your house, and prayer comes and you rise and rise. And maybe you are not even saying it, and you are still rising. So it means that there is not much importance in the song as in where people are many, so that there is unity in focus. But I pray thee that we shall and we must gear ourselves so that the Prince of Greece can come also. The Prince of Greece is another level, upper. Amen? Verse 21. But I will tell you what is not in the scripture of truth. No one upholds me against these except Michael, your prince. So, Michael is there. Prince Michael is the angel that upholds us. When you are praying and the angels come, let us yearn to soar. In fact, when you are praying and the presence has come down, don't end it. Until now you feel, I'm just speaking from my head, then you can just end it. But when the presence of God is still down, pray and pray and pray, and allow people to pray deeper, deeper, deeper. Amen? I think I'll end it at that. So may God bless us so much. It's good now you know how to gauge your level, you know where you are, according to Pastor Basil a while ago. And this is good. Amen? Yes. So I believe that at one time, each and every one of us will be yearning and gearing and saying, yes, even me today I want to see, give me this opportunity. Give me this opportunity to preach today. Give me this opportunity. Well, that opportunity is there. I'm just waiting for people to come and ask. Dare me, I give you the pulpit. Dare me, I give you. You know, to some extent, when we are empowered, we may take everything to ourselves. That is selfish. Because of the program, I'm going to sing, I'm going to do everything, you just sit there and listen. No, it's not like that. In fact, we are here, brothers one to another, to help build the body of Christ. Just as much as the eye is there, it needs the nose, The nose needs the mouth so that this body is complete. We need one another. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Let us rise. I read now. Come and pray. Let's come and pray as we continue.
Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before you this evening. We thank you, Jehovah, Lord, for your grace that has been with us this morning. We thank you, Father, for your power that has rested upon our lives. We thank you, Father, for your glory that has been with us each and every day of our lives. Thank you, Father, for your word that has been directing us this day, Jehovah, Lord. Thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit that has been leading us, that has been strengthening us, that has been guiding us in everything that we do today. My Father, my God, we give God the glory, my Father, because of this fire you brought us. We thank you, Father, because we are not the same as we came in. Jehovah, Lord, we thank you. Let your power rest upon our lives. Let your light shine in every area of our lives. Let your peace that is of God that surpasses all understanding to be our portion. Guide us throughout this week, Jehovah, Lord. Lead us to every step that we take, Jehovah, Lord. Empower us, my Father. Even as we go before you, Jehovah, Lord, each and every day, help us to pray. Help us to seek your face. Help us, Jehovah, Lord, to remain faithful to you. My Father, my God, guide us in everything that we do, Jehovah, Lord. May you remain faithful in all that we do. Help us to follow your footsteps, my Father. It's not all about ourselves, but it's all about you in our lives. It's all about you in everything that we do, Jehovah. It's for your glory, my Father, in everything that we put our hands to do. We thank you and we bless you. Holy. As we come out from this place, Jehovah, Lord, bless our going out, my Father. Bless the work of our hands. Let your glory rest upon the work of our hands, my Father. Even as we meet again, Jehovah, Lord, you shall take all the glory. Help us to pray out times. Help us, Jehovah, Lord, to seek your face. Help us, Jehovah, Lord, to stand in faithfulness. Help us, Jehovah, Lord, to seek your face each and every area of our lives. My Father, my God, because without you, we are nothing. We want to see, we want to hear from you, we want to walk with you always. For it's in Jesus' name we do pray, trust, and believe. Amen. And in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forever. Amen.